Hello everyone, and welcome to one of the craziest games we've had in a while on this channel. It was played, I believe yesterday, or maybe a day before yesterday, in the Karpov-Poikovsky tournament. Krishnan Sasikiran versus Vladislav Artemiev, the young Russian superstar who seems to just, you know, be skyrocketing with his rating, you know, getting very, very close to the 2800 mark. But this game, it's really... a lot of you have suggested it, and when I say a lot, I mean a lot. So I knew the game was crazy even before I saw it. You know, the craziness of the game goes up with the number of suggestions. That's how it works. But yeah, without further ado, let's just check it out, and then maybe you can help me out to figure out a title for this very nice game. So without further ado, Sasikiran has the white pieces, and he opens with e4. Let me just fix that. We have c5 by Artemiev. The Sicilian defense is on the board. Knight f3. We have d6 and now d4. C captures, knight captures. We have knight to f6, knight to c3, and a6. The knight of defense is on the board. And f3. White probably has some ideas of developing the bishop, the queen, and then maybe even pushing on the king side, depending on how black approaches the position. We have e6 by Artemiev. Bishop to e3, and now b5. Already expanding on the queen side. We have queen to d2, preparing to castle queenside, and now b4, already forcing the knight to decide where to go. We have knight to a4, and now comes knight b to d7. We have queenside castle by Sasikiran, and now queen to a5, harassing the knight here on a4. Sasikiran, of course, defends it. We have b3, and now bishop to b7. Nicely developing, you have to make room for this rook to enter the game, and now taking advantage of this very nice pin here with a3. So of course the pawn cannot capture, and white wants to capture on b4. We have queen back to c7, and now comes a captures on b4. So just nicely capturing, kicking the queen back, and now comes d5. And here bishop back to f2, and this is this position has been reached before. There are a few known moves here. E5 is a known move here, where Gordievsky defeated Benjamin Bok in this position, but also last year in the Gibraltar Tradewise Masters Tournament, Hikaru Nakamura also had this position against Nils Grandelius, and there bishop to d6 was played, same as in this game. The only difference is that Nakamura won that game. He played e captures on d5, and then after knight captures, only then did Nakamura go bishop to g3. But here, after bishop to d6, Sasikiran says that bishop to g3 is a slight improvement to Nakamura's first capturing on d5 and then going on g3, as I've seen the interview with Sasikiran after the game, which I will put in the description below if you're interested to check it out. It's on Chess Base India's channel. It will be the first link you will see in the description below. Very nice interview. But okay, bishop to g3, wanting to exchange the dark square bishop. Once the dark square bishops are off the board, all of these dark square weaknesses around white's king will not be felt all that much. We have bishop captures, h captures, and now you could go for this pawn grab. If queen captures, white will just get a lot of activity for this, because after e captures and knight captures, you will go c4. Push the knight back, then you're gonna go rook h3, push the queen back, and then bishop to d3, and white will just develop all of his pieces for this doubled g pawn. So of course Artemiev is not interested in that. He plays e captures on d captures on e4, and now comes not recapturing but rather g4, saying now, okay, now if you castle, then g5 is coming, and already white is having a nice attack. So here Artemiev went knight to d5, and now comes bishop to c4. If you capture, then it's not all that great. Knight will just return, and now g5 isn't all that great because the e4 pawn is hanging. You no longer have the f3 pawn. So here we have bishop to c4 by Sasikiran, and now knight to e5. Captures on d5, we have e captures on d5, and only now does Sasikiran capture on e4. We have f captures on e4, d captures on e4, and now knight to f5. And here black has to decide what to do. His king is under heavy pressure, and black doesn't really have a good counterplay on the queen side. Rook to c8 will be an idea at some point, and this queen will have to keep an eye on the pawn here, but you can always block it with knight c5. You already have the threat of knight captures on g7. So how do you defend here? It's not pleasant, but it's best to castle. Here Artemiev castles, and now you have to decide what to do here, and it's really just a crazy position. Where definitely pause the video and try to you know, just get in the mood of the position and try and figure out what you would play here. I'll give you a couple of seconds while I have a nice sip of my water. For those of you who found any move here, congratulations, you are an excellent player, because there are a lot of good moves here. First, we have to look into this rook captures on h7. It's really a crazy line, which goes after king captures on h7, rook h1 check, king goes back, now queen g5. Threatening checkmate, and now after you block it with f6, now queen h5, and now you control this diagonal and this line. So after rook a to c8, threatening mate here, white blocks, checkmate, knight c5, but then bishop to d5. And here it's really crazy. White, of course, is better here, but it's so hard to calculate everything. After queen h7 check, king f7, now you don't even capture right away. First you go rook d1, attack the bishop, and also try to cut off the king from escaping on the queen side. But now you get knight d3 check. One of the, you know, subtleties of the position. C captures, and now queen to f4 check will prevent, after king b1, will prevent you from capturing on g7. And here, again, it's just crazy. You can even capture the rook here after something like this, but, you know, it's, how will you assess this position from that position where you have to decide whether to sacrifice the rook on h7? So it's one of the moves that, if you found, you know, just congratulations. There's also knight captures on g7. It's very nice if the king actually captures. Then it's just, you know, a quick checkmate. The problem is the queen doesn't have to capture the knight. The knight can go to g6, for example, knight here. But then after knight h5, white will again have some very nice threats, like the threat of checkmate. For example, after f5, you can go g5. And now, what do you play here? Again, very hard to decide for this line with white. For example, if queen e5 here, threatening checkmate, there are a lot of ideas for black too. So here, Sasikiran did not sacrifice on h7. He did not play knight captures on g7. Rather, he played queen to c3. And I know what you're thinking. You know, two such nice moves, and you offer a queen trade. What kind of an immortal game is this? Well, it's not actually a queen trade offer, because if you capture here, then you're getting checkmated. Knight e7 check, it's the famous checkmating sequence. Rook captures on h7, king captures on rook h1 check. The knight controls these two squares, and the black king has nowhere to go. You will have to block it, and rook h3 is checkmate. So this queen to c3 is not really an offer of a queen trade. It's, you know, just asking black, what are you gonna do? So here Artemiev goes rook f to c8, now defends the queen, and also, you know, prevents this nice checkmating idea, because now the king can also run away to f8. So here we have knight to c5, we already mentioned that was a very important resource for white, and now f6, just cementing that knight in. But the problem now for black is that Sasikiran can transfer the game over to the king side. We have queen to h3, threatening to capture here, and now h6. And now again, how do you continue this game in this position? I'll give you a couple of seconds. Just a beautiful, beautiful idea. For those of you who were able to do it, congratulations. You are an excellent pusher of pawns. And for those of you who just want to enjoy the show, the idea is g5. And it's always beautiful when ideas like these work. And now, if you capture like this, of course, you don't want to open up the h file. It's just queen h8 check, king f7 captures here. King has to move, and rook to h8 will be checkmate, so not an option. So Artemiev decided to capture with the f pawn, although you don't even want to play anything else and allow white to capture. So here f captures on g5 was played, but now comes the move you had to find to even play g5. If you haven't, again, it's such a beautiful game. Again, feel free to pause the video and try to find this very nice move. For those of you, again, who were able to do it, congratulations, you are just an excellent lifter of rooks. And for those of you who just want to enjoy the show, rook to d7, just beautiful. You have to capture the rook. If you move the queen, rook captures on g7, just wins. The knight and rook are attacking it. So here you have to capture, knight captures, and now the move you also had to see, knight captures on h6 with check. So really crazy, and what do you do now? You have to capture the knight. If you play something like king to the h file, then you just get knight g8 check, and you get this already mate, a similar mate that like the one we've already seen, followed by rook h8 checkmate. If you don't, if you go to king to f8, then knight e6 check just picks up the queen, and it's sufficient for a nice win. So after knight captures, we have g captures, and now queen to e6 check. King g7, queen captures on h6, king to f7, and now queen back to e6 check. King g7, and here comes queen to e7 check. King to g6, now queen to h7 check. King to f6, and now finally recapturing, but this time with check. You have to make sure it's with check because you don't want to experience checkmate where when you're on the verge of creating an immortal game. We have king to e6, and here queen to g6 check. What can black do? You can capture the knight, but then it's again a very nice checkmate. King d8, just queen g8 checkmate. So here after queen to g6, Artemiev went king to d5, and he allowed this beautiful finisher. Of course, you all see it. It's rook to d1, and this is now checkmate. The queen is controlling all of these squares. Knight controls these squares. Pawn controls this one. And of course, the rook now prevents the king from escaping downward. So it's checkmate. So just a beautiful, beautiful game. 35 moves with king being checkmated on d5. It's just a modern day masterpiece. And like I said, do help me out with the name for this immortal game, as I'm gonna read all of the comments, of course, tomorrow when I will be having my coffee or tea, if I will still be feeling sick, and then we're gonna decide on the name for this beautiful game. So yeah, that's it. A beautiful game by Krishan Sasikaran versus Vladislav Artemiev. And if you've seen any game we've shown by Artemiev, it's just extremely difficult to beat this guy, and the way Sasikaran did it is, you know, just amazing. But yeah, I would like to thank Tom Broning, Chokalingam Hariharan, Paul Jacobs, Fabio Reis, and John Schmidt for a contribution to my channel. Thank you a lot. I really appreciate it. As usual, you can check two of my previous videos here. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you soon, going back to the Altibox Norway Championship and, of course, checking up on your suggestions. Thank you all. I will see you soon. Have an excellent rest of your Sunday.